Hey, Measuring Hero, Jay here. We are about an 11-minute walk from my flat. We're right here up in Aalen University. We thought we would take you here to have a look at the Materialforschung Institute here in Aalen University, or the Materials Research Institute here at Aalen. And Tim, thanks for coming to show us around. We really appreciate it.
Yeah, hi Jay, welcome to Aalen University. It's a bit cold, let's just go inside.
Let's go inside.
So Jay, let's just start here at our, I call it the core facility. What we do here is we get our materials in every funky form. We have to cut little pieces out of it that sure. are better for preparation. Therefore, we have these different types of cutting machines, all water-cooled cutting machines, because you do not want to alter the microstructure due to heat.
Okay.
Except you're doing heat treatment, but that's another story. The next thing, if you have these little pieces, you want to have them handleable. So sure. we embed it in these standard round specimen. And with this, we go to the next area here, where we do the semi-automated preparation.
Okay.
So grinding and polishing. Our students, they have to learn to do it manually. But if you are advanced, you will have... You can go to the semi-automated machines. Let's just go here. This is the...
That's what my dad used to tell me to do. When he first taught me how to shave, he made me use a razor. And then after I cut myself over and over again, he gave me the electric razor so that I could...
Yeah, basically. same principle here, same principle here, yeah. What these machines basically do is they take these specimens here and they... press them against a rotating grinding disc okay. where we have different grain sizes, different
sure.
Diamonds, suspensions to polish away layer by layer the material and to get to a mirror finish. Sure. What we have here is a steel sample. You see the mirror finish.
Yep.
Under the light microscope, you will basically see nothing except you have some oxides or sulfide inclusions there.
Mm-hmm.
You have to etch it. This is done here in these fumuts.
Okay.
So you selectively remove faces and material and get a good contrast in the light microscope.
So basically, long story short, because you're obviously a materials research facility, so you know your materials, you know what it takes to prepare a sample
yeah.
for observation.
that's correct. And we have all different kinds of materials
okay.
here. So we have energy conversion and energy storage materials, so
mm-hmm.
Hard and soft magnetic materials
okay.
where we have experts. We have experts in battery technology, so energy storage at battery aging and battery production, and of course standard construction materials as well as additive manufacturing. So we also do metal
okay.
3D printing here,
sure.
materials development, mostly materials development, not so much process development.
Yeah.
And for the special materials like magnets and batteries, we also have special preparation equipment because magnets tend to corrode under standard atmospheric conditions, so they have to be prepared water-free with alcohol-based
okay.
suspensions. And for the batteries, we have these special fume hoods here installed
mm-hmm.
Because the aerosols that are created during preparation are not that healthy.
Not good for you.
Not good for you.
Don't breathe that.
No, don't breathe that.
All right.
Yeah. Okay, and when we are finished with preparation, when we have this mm-hmm. nice and shiny, defect-free surface, we go straight to the light microscopy lab, and I think we should go there and have a look.
Where the magic happens.
Yeah, where the magic happens.
All right.
So, yeah, now this is where the magic
yeah.
happens. Yeah. So... this is our light microscopy lab.
Okay.
We have your whole portfolio of upright materials, microscopes here, all automated.
Okay.
And also, so the computer always knows what the microscope is capable of and what the setting of the microscope is, so no time or no room for errors like scaling or
sure,
whatever.
Sure.
And we also do a lot of machine learning based image analysis.
Okay.
So therefore we need large areas and therefore we definitely need automated microscopes.
Right.
What we also have here is confocal microscopy. So
mm-hmm.
you can do measurements of wear and
Oh sure, the smart proof.
Yeah, the smart proof.
Oh man, I love that. I love that machine. Yeah.
And also a digital microscope, that, like right behind you, the Smart Zoom 5.
Yep.
And just, we also have two manual microscopes, so I was not totally honest, but also ZEISS microscopes, just for quality control or controlling your preparation quality. Yeah.
Great, great. So I think what I'm seeing so far is the fact that in your research institute, you can absolutely start from material preparation, sample preparation, independent of what the materials are. You have a full facility based on the different materials, and then to be able to prep it, get it ready, and then you have the entire suite of light microscopic portfolio to do observations.
Exactly this, and also include all the, let's call it translating the from a nice image to sheer numbers, so
perfect.
Quantitative analysis. And if the resolution here for the light microscope is not sufficient anymore, we just grab our samples, go down to the basement, to the SEM lab. So Jay, I already showed you what we are capable of doing with cutting, grinding, polishing, light microscopy. And here we are in the lab where we also assemble batteries. We also do materials development for batteries. There are some solid state battery stuff I'm not allowed to talk about.
Okay.
But there's also lithium ion battery, which is state of the art technology. And what we do here is we do aging tests. So here we have a lot of these pre-assembled cells that we assemble in a glove box. And then all this wiring you see here, we do aging cycling tests. So charging, discharging, and until the battery dies, and then we can see
then
and
you
learn.
Analyze it.
Yeah, then we analyze and learn how to do it.
Oh, so it's not just figuring out at the end what materials work best for batteries. You're actually on the cutting edge of what's to come.
Yeah, we can also put new stuff in the batteries and see what comes out. Yeah.
Well, I look forward to using your technology in my next car or my next phone or
yeah, probably.
All of it.
But what you know, what is also important, it's not just the battery to store the energy, you want to convert the energy. On the one side, from wind to the battery, or from the battery to the motor of your new bike, e-scooter, or car. So let's just head over to the next lab, and I will show you where we do our magnetic magic, where magnets, hard and soft magnets, are produced.
Awesome, let's go.
So Jay, here we are in the magnetic manufacturing lab, and what we do here is we make our own magnets, so experimental alloys. We first melt all the alloys here, and as they are very sensitive to oxygen, we transfer them again to a glove box system.
Gotta go right here.
Yeah, right behind you. We do the milling, so we have a powder, and as normal magnets are powder metallurgy stuff, we then press them in a strong magnetic field and also do the sintering process, so basically baking the magnets finished in the glove box system. And when they are finished sintering, they are magnets. And of course, magnets have to be measured magnetically, and this is done in the basement, and there we will go now.
Okay, let's do it. Okay, that's really loud.
Yeah.
What's going on in here?
Yeah, this is exactly the lab we were going to. This is where we do the magnetic measurements.
Okay.
What you hear is the helium reliquifier.
Helium reliquifier.
Yeah,
okay.
Basically we need the liquid helium to cool down the measurement device. This is a vibration magnetometer to basically measure magnetic properties, and it can be cooled down to 2 Kelvin.
That's cold.
That's very cold, but it is loud, and so I think we should just move on to the next lab. So this is the lab where we do the magnetic measurements, and right next door is the EM lab, so let's have a look. Yeah. Jay, welcome to the basement in our electron microscopy lab. As I said, when the resolution of the light microscope is not sufficient anymore, we go down to
bring the
electron microscopy, and there we can do all the correlative microscopy stuff. So easily finding the the areas of interest in a light microscope in the SEM, as we have both ZEISS systems and they like to talk to each other. And so
funny how we designed it that way, right?
Yeah. what we have here is our Sigma. It's basically our working horse SEM with all the analytics. So we have EDS, WDS, and EBSDs for chemical analysis and crystallography, and basically all of our research groups, be it additive manufacturing, magnets, batteries, they all use this system. It's very highly frequented.
Sure.
And if this is still not sufficient anymore, we will go over to our, or to my baby here, the cross beam, where we have not just the electron beam, but also the focused ion beam.
Okay.
To very precisely prepare cross sections.
Okay.
And do, do milling. And we also have analytics here. So two EDS detectors, EBSD for 3D EBSD, 3D microstructure characterization down to the nanometer scale.
That's insane. Down to the nanometer scale.
Yeah, that's insane. Yeah, this is basically it. But yeah, basically here ends the microstructural thing. The next thing would be crystallography based. So you know, X-ray diffraction analysis. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we have a very special device here. So let's just go to the next lab and I can show you here. Now what we have here is the XRD system. So basically XRD, X-ray diffraction, is standard analysis in crystallography. What we have here as a specialty is we can put an oven inside and do in situ testing.
Oh geez, okay.
So if you heard of heat treatment of steel, like Martin Sittig transformation, we can observe this here.
Wow.
We can heat up the sample and see the crystallography change in the sample.
Wow. Internal structure, obviously.
Yeah, internal structure based on the atom lattice scale. And with this, I think we can wrap up the whole story. We can have the, except for TEM, we have the whole materials characterization stuff here at the Institute.
Well, yeah, you do definitely do a lot from material prep to research to battery, way more than I never thought was happening here. It's so darn close to my house, too.
Yeah.
You mentioned something about additive manufacturing. What do you guys do?
Yeah, basically this is what I did not show you because it's my research, and I would like to invite you for a separate tour where I show you all the additive manufacturing stuff we do, as this is my special type of research and my little thing to tell you.
I am definitely going to take you up on that because additive is definitely something in the future. I've talked to some of the team over in the United States. I'm definitely going to take you up on that and come back. So you will see me a lot.
Yeah,
here.
Always welcome. Awesome. But for now, I think have a safe trip home this 11-minute walk.
Yeah.
And then see you soon.
All right, Tim, thank you for joining us and showing us around. We really appreciate it.
Bye, Jay.
And with you out there, I want to thank you for joining us this and every Thursday. We hope you continue to stay safe and stay healthy, and we'll see you next Thursday. Tschüss.